Hi, this is Manan Shalvi. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this selective letter reveal in LumaFusion using just one title. The letters are revealed in seemingly random order and they disappear in the same manner. Spoiler alert, they're not really random. Here's a variation of the effect with video playing inside the letters. The method used in this tutorial became possible due to an interesting finding by Punk80, who is a friend of this channel and frequent collaborator. Thanks, Punk80. Here's what he found. When editing a title, you can select just parts of the text. You can then change settings for the selected text only. For example, font, size, face color settings, and edge settings. This works great for the effect that is the subject of this tutorial because, as you'll see soon, we'll need a different color for each letter in the text. Without this finding, you'd have to add a separate text element to the title for each letter, which would have rendered this effect impractical. One important thing to notice though, make those changes to selected text the last thing you do in the text element. Some text level changes will override and erase those individual changes. Let's get started with a new 30 frames per second LumaFusion project already containing a background video of your choice and a title centered in the track above it. For this tutorial, the title is 10 seconds long. Edit the title. Set the font and the text of your choice. Make sure that there are no edges or shadows. Now, let's color each letter with a different tone of gray. I defined a 15 equally spaced gray tones range to choose the colors from. Select a letter in the middle of the text and change the face color to the darker color in the range. Select a second letter farther apart from the first one, and change the face color to the next color in the range. Once the effect is done, the order of appearance of the letters will be determined by their color brightness from lighter to darker. In order to make the reveal look random, assign distinctly different colors to letters that are next to each other. Keep assigning different colors to each letter in the text. This is how it looks after all letters have been assigned a color. If you have less letters than the 15 used in this example, consider increasing the space between the colors in the range. If you have more than 15 letters, consider decreasing the spacing or repeating some colors. Now, tap on the Colors and Effects tab. Add the original preset. Set the contrast to 0.60. And set Gamma to 0.01. Decrease brightness until only one letter shows in white color. A As you can see, the remaining letters show in black color. To hide them, tap on the Frame and Fit tab, expand the blending section, and change the blend mode to screen. With that out of the way, tap again on the Colors and Effects tab to continue creating the reveal animation. Expand the original preset that you've previously created. Make sure that you are at the beginning of the clip and add a keyframe. Move to the 1 second and 15 frames mark. This will be the point where the text will be fully revealed. Start increasing brightness. A keyframe will be automatically created. Notice how the letters start being revealed. Stop at the lowest value of brightness where all the letters are visible. This is how it looks so far. Now, reverse the process at the end of the clip to selectively hide the letters as shown. Let's add a dynamic touch by having the text slightly grow throughout the animation. Tap on the Frame and Fit tab. Expand the Size and Position section. Make sure that you are at the end of the clip. Notice that the size is 100%. Add a keyframe. Go to the beginning of the clip and reduce the size to 90%. A keyframe will be automatically created. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks now. This works great if the color of the text is white. Now let's see how to change the color of the text. Duplicate the title. It will be automatically placed on the third track, right above the original title. Edit the original title on the second track. Tap on the Frame and Fit tab. Expand the blending section. And change the blend mode to Silhouette Luma. Exit back to the timeline. Let's hide the third track for a moment to see what we did. Edit the title on the third track. Keep in mind that this clip uses the screen blend mode. Tap on the Colors and Effects tab. Expand the original preset that you've previously created. Go keyframe by keyframe, setting the same or different tint colors for each keyframe. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks now. Now, let's display video inside the text. This could be done with chroma key, but the enhanced screen blend mode method I covered in a previous tutorial will give you a better result. Start by deleting the title on the third track. As you may recall, the title on the second track has the Silhouette Luma blend mode set. Add the video that will show inside the text to the main track. Make a copy of the title and place it above the video that will show inside the text. adjust the duration of the video so it is the same as the title. Edit the title above the video. Tap on the Frame and Fit tab. Expand the blending section and change the blend mode to Stencil Luma. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks now. Export the project. Add the video that you just exported into the third track just above the existing clips. Cut and move the video as shown. Edit the video on the second track. Tap on the Frame and Fit tab, expand the blending section, and change the blend mode to Screen. Exit back to the timeline, and we are done. This is how it looks now. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you are notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you on the next one.